Hello, happy site owners and webmasters. Mayanna here with Blog Aid today for December 1st, 2017. And it's the first day of WordCampUS. And I just wanted to report in, you know, I did a little bit of live streaming. Actually, I recorded some things on my phone and then streamed up to it later and took just a few shots because I was busy talking with people. So one of the absolute highlights of the day was, as a matter of fact, the first person that I bumped into was Joost de Valk of Yoast SEO. I'm so thrilled about that. So, I mean, to meet him in person is just wonderful. And he had a few devs that he was talking to, so I didn't get to interview him, but I did get to say thank you for all that he does. And Team Yoast was around, you know, so I was so happy to see them and get a chance to publicly thank them for all the work because, you know, they do so much of it. And these are people he pays, you know, to travel all over and do all this volunteer work for us and that kind of thing. So maybe you saw that video on my Blog Aid Facebook page is where I uploaded it at the conference. I'll have it up on YouTube a little later tonight along with this one because I'm streaming over on my Blog Aid Facebook page for this one too. And also, I talked to several vendors. I didn't have time to interview them because we were running in between some of the talks that were going on, and everybody was going different directions, you know, with the first day and whatever. So, the really huge thing of the day was the very last talk of the day, and it was on Gutenberg. And I have to tell you, that was so worthwhile. Now, I got to go up to the test booth that they've got there for everybody to sit down and put their hands on, you know, Gutenberg and try it. And sorry, I lost my train of thought, but all the different things that Gutenberg can do, and they'll work with you and that kind of thing. And so it was pretty crowded up there while I was there, so I didn't get to put my hands on it today, but I will tomorrow because it's the latest greatest of it. And plus having the devs right there talking to you about it, you know, that's a really big deal in answering questions and whatever. But I have to tell you, this talk, I mean, the room was freaking huge. The picture that I've got of it that I uploaded to my Facebook page, and I'll have a blog post with all of a sudden. The picture does not even do justice to how many people were in that room. It was packed. It was standing room only. And I know a lot of people come to these things to hear Matt Mullenweg's State of the Word address. Well, let me tell you, I think this one just about outdid it because Gutenberg is the big thing. It's the pivot point for WordPress. And what I heard in that talk really cleared a lot of things up. And I'll have a whole post for you on Monday wrapping up everything, but basically the way that they're having to put Gutenberg in right now is not what it's eventually going to be, and how it is open for the whole community to do this. And guys, they're looking at 5 years down the road for virtual reality web, you know, web VR. That's what they're looking at, and how we're going to be able as users of the web to customize things. It's coming. I mean, virtual reality right now requires some big headset. That's not always going to be the case. 5 years from now, the tech marches on, and WordPress is going to be there for it. And I think what they were talking about is the way we're going to experience the web at all. I mean, everybody. It's not going to be just this little square thing on a monitor anymore. And so we've got to get ready for these shifts and things that are happening, and it's going to require a fundamental shift in how WordPress is done. So right now it's going into the text editor and it's occupying that little spot. You know, you've got a header, a sidebar, a footer, and a content area, and it's occupying the area of the content as kind of a text editor thing. That's not the dream, okay? That's just how they're bumping it into here. It's the only place that it can occupy. It will occupy the whole thing, and it'll be radically different from what we know now. And so it's pretty exciting, but there were a lot of questions about stuff too. So, I mean, we're not there. Not everybody's not really super clear, but man, did that really help for us to kind of catch the whole vision. I have not seen it put that way anywhere else that I've read about Gutenberg. And, you know, that it really helped a lot. So I know a lot of people couldn't attend WordCampUS directly, but if you bought a ticket, you could see the stream. I hope that they put that one talk up somewhere where everybody can see it, because I think it's really important. It just really cleared up a bunch of stuff. So that was very, very exciting today. also ran into some of my Nashville peeps, had dinner with them, you know, some of the folks that I haven't seen from our meetup groups there and caught up with since I moved out of Nashville, and really haven't had time. We're just all buried in work, which is great, and kind of catch up with what's going on with some of my peeps and have dinner with my friends and that kind of thing in Nashville. So it's been a really good day. I just wanted to drop on here for a minute and kind of give you a recap of it. And tomorrow, of course, is Matt's State of the Word address. And then I'm also going to do the Gutenberg test. And then I'm going to meet up with the Studio Press peeps. They're kind of having an in-between Matt's address and the after party. They're having a little party. And I'm going to meet up with them. And I'm going to meet up with the Ninja Forums people. A lot of vendors for that, you know, get a chance to talk. And A2, the guys at A2 said, hey, Mayanna, we see you're going to be at WordCampUS. We want to meet up with you. Woo! And so, you know, several of the vendors that we all know and love. And getting a chance to sit down with these people personally, that's what it's all about. You know, WordCamp is great for that. So I'm really looking forward to tomorrow as well. And then I caught up with a couple of people. They're going to be doing Contributors Day on Sunday. And I'm hoping that it kind of fell apart on the communication about this women in tech and doing speakers, you know, training speakers and that kind of thing. And the communication kind of fell out. So I'm hoping that I can find Jill Bender and a few other people that are putting that together for Contributors Day. So I'm looking at really forward to hanging out with the vendors and all the peeps up in that area and that kind of thing tomorrow. So I'll have a report from WordCampUS Day 2 in Nashville for you tomorrow. All right, y'all have a good night, and I'll see you online.